number that was only 23 off the actual count. The actual count was 923. That seems like a lot. 923, they've all been counted, let me tell you. And the winner with a count of 899 is Barb Cook.
Thank you, Linda, and thank you for taking the time to count us. We have a very busy week this week here at Bethany, and so I'm not going to go over quite everything, but I'm going to try to hit a couple of highlights for the week. This Monday night, we will start our Love Does study. If you are interested in this study, please see me immediately following the service. If you ordered a book for me, we have them. Please see me after the service as well. We'll also have our second week Finding Sanctuary study this Wednesday from 1 to 2 in the afternoon. And we will have our contemplative service this Thursday night at 6 o'clock. This is a meditative and repetitive service to help us center on God and in Christ in our lives. It will be a wonderful opportunity to observe God through repetitive choruses and to experience God in prayer, scripture reading, and communion. Finally, next Sunday, we will have our church picnic. We are looking forward to one of the best days of the year we always have. We will be out at the Roslyn Center next Sunday, and we ask that if you are not on the fellowship committee, or even if you are in the fellowship department, bring a side item. The fellowship department will take care of the main course, so please bring a side item or a dessert. Now let's focus our hearts and our minds on God and on the worship of God. So we prepare for our worship with our time of the hour and then our prayer. please stand as you are able for our call to worship, processional hymn, and invocation. We find it easy to say, yes, we will follow Christ. Let us place our trust always in His guidance.
Forever and ever.
comes from the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 30, verses 15 through 4. See, I set before you today life and prosperity, death and destruction. For I command you today to love the Lord your God, to walk in his ways, and to keep his commands, decrees, and laws. Then you will live and increase, and the Lord your God will bless you in the land you are entering to possess. But if your heart turns away, and you are not obedient, and if you are drawn away to bow down to other gods and worship them, I declare to you this day that you will certainly be destroyed. You will not live long in the land you are crossing the Jordan to enter and possess. This day, I call heaven and earth as witnesses against you, that I have set before you life and death, blessings and curses. Now choose life, so that you and your children may live, and that you may love the Lord your God, listen to his voice, and hold fast to him. For the Lord is your life, and he will give you many years in the land he swore to give to your fathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Amen. We've come to our time of sharing of joys and concerns. Do we have any joys or concerns to lift up from the congregation? Please raise your hand and Christopher will come to you with a microphone.
Please bear with me. One is that I found out that one of my cousins in Georgia, where it's not passed away very recently, so please pray for my mom. Gwen Scott, who grew up here as Gwen Taylor, and her husband and her children, and the death of her youngest son. Second is Cassie Wilk and Colby are in the prayer list. She is in the NICU, Mommy's doing just fine. They have a slight infection question that they're trying to check right now. But they have also lost one member of their family this week, and another one had a serious heart attack. So they are going through a lot of joy, very nervous, and grief at the same time.
So we pray for Gwen and David Scott and also their son, and also pray for Casey and Colby. Colby is still in the NICU. Charles.
And my wife, Shirley, her condition continues to worsen. She's in and out of sleep most of the time. She wakes up, she recognizes people in the leg and drift back into sleep again. She knows the end is near, so please keep my family in your prayers.
Definitely keep Charles and Shirley and their family in our prayers. Shirley is not known. Other joys or concerns to lift up.
I'd like to add Kim Newland to our prayer list. Kim is a friend of mine who runs a women's ministry organization called Sweet Monday. She's a cancer survivor. She fought against a particularly aggressive form of cancer, double mastectomy, the whole works. She recently found out that her cancer has returned. She has a daughter who is a freshman in college, and her husband is a teacher at Legion. Please keep Kim Newland in your prayer.
Pray for Kim Newland. Others.
I have a joy that Sandy's back with us today.
It is good to see Sandy back.
I'd like you all to keep my son and his wife in your prayers. My son lost his brother-in-law this last week. And they've been up to Wilmington, Delaware for a funeral. Thank you.
This is for Steve, correct? It's a prayer for Steve and his wife, who lost his brother. He's coming around for you.
I just asked for prayers for my father. He'll be leaving the hospital tomorrow and going back to Spring Arbor. But he's very weak, and I'm not sure that he will be able to continue to assist the living.
Prayers for Rosa Gibbons as he returns to Spring Arbor. Other joys or concerns to lift up this morning?
I have a joy this morning. Good to see Carolyn Moore here after her battle with surgery, and it's just great to see her.
It is wonderful. Wonderful to see Carolyn back with us.
One thing I forgot to mention, the present plan is to bring Shirley home from Beaufort this coming Tuesday under hospice care.
Thank you, Charles. Also want to update that Jim Evans did have his procedure on Wednesday. He stayed in the hospital overnight and is back at home doing well, recovering. So please pray for Jim and Dean Evans as he recovers from his procedure. Any other joys or concerns to lift up?
Thank you.
pray. Loving Lord, we present to you these tithes and offerings, a symbol of our trust in you and our trust in one another. Bind us and bind these offerings to do your will, to build your kingdom, to expand it upon the earth. We pray all of this in Jesus' name. Amen. You may be seated. If the boys and girls will please come forward for the children's moment.
Old Testament faith is in there 58 times the word. In the New Testament, it's 280 times. Okay? So I thought, well, that is pretty interesting. Well, I made an acrostic point for us today. Those of you that are in your upper grades at school, what's an acrostic for? You ever made one? No? You have? Okay. So it's when you take the word and you write the word going down vertically, and then beside it you put words that go with it, that start with that letter. It doesn't have to rhyme, but it can. Right? Would you like to be my pointer? Tell them, school teacher. Alright? Point to the big T. Trust. Who do we trust in every day? God, very good. Go to the R. Rely on Him. How many of you like sweet frogs? Like ice cream and fruit and sweet frogs? Would you know they have Christian ice cream? Because sweet frogs is a Christian-based company. Do you know what frogs stand for? Fully rely on God. How many of you did not know that? That's what frog stands for. They have t-shirts you can buy. And the word frog is written out like an acrostic poem, and it means fully rely on God. So they have Christian ice cream as opposed to other places. You, the U is for understand God has a plan for you. He knows each and every one of you, and He's got a plan for you. S, stand on His promises. Stand fast and firm as a Christian. Don't follow those boys and girls who are leading you astray. You stand firm. And the last T is telling others about Jesus. Can you do all that? Yes, you can. All right, so that is our lesson on trust. Some of you are looking a little wilted. Squirt bottle has water. Wait a minute, you didn't trust me? You didn't trust that I wasn't going to support you? Just a trick. Okay, let's fold our hands and say prayer hands. Father, it is us again, your children at Bethany. We pray that you will open our hearts so that we can be good boys and girls, that we can be trustworthy, and that we can trust us. Off to Children's Church.
Thank you.
saying, "This is my body, which is broken for you. Take and eat of it in remembrance of me." In the same way, after supper, he took the cup. He blessed it, and he poured it, saying, "This is my blood, the blood of the new covenant, poured out for the forgiveness of the sins of men. Take and drink of it, all of you, in remembrance of me."
Bread of life. continue to pray. Most gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for the meaningful summons of the Lord's Supper, for that divine love which makes us whole in you. We recognize thy presence, and we know that without thee we can do nothing. Bless the contents of this cup as we partake together. In the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
The cup of salvation. For as often as we eat of the bread and drink of the cup, proclaim Christ's death and resurrection until he comes again. You'll please take a moment to turn to those around you and offer a blessing of the peace of Christ to those nearest to you. Thank you. This morning's New Testament reading can be found in your pew Bibles on page 1860. It comes from the letter to Philemon, chapter 1, verses 1 through 21. Paul, a prisoner of Christ Jesus, and Timothy, our brother. To Philemon, our dear friend and fellow worker. To Apphia, our sister. To Archippus, our fellow soldier. And to the church that meets in your house. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. I always thank my God as I remember you in my prayers, because I hear about your faith in the Lord Jesus and your love for all the saints. I pray that you may be active in sharing your faith, so that you will have a full understanding of every good thing we have in Christ. Your love has given me great joy and encouragement, because you, brother, have refreshed the hearts of the saints. Therefore, although in Christ I could be bold and order you to do what you ought to do, yet I appeal to you on the basis of love. I then, as Paul, an old man and now also a prisoner of Christ Jesus, I appeal to you for my son, Onesimus, who became my son while I was in chains. Formerly, he was useless to you, but now he has become useful both to you and to me. I am sending him, who is my very heart, back to you. I would have liked to keep him with me so that he could take your place in helping me while I am in chains for the gospel. But I did not want to do anything without your consent, so that any favor you do will be spontaneous and not forced. Perhaps the reason he was separated from you for a little while was that you might have him back for good. No longer as a slave, but better than a slave, as a dear brother. He is very dear to me, but even dearer to you, both as a man and as a brother in the Lord. So if you consider me a partner, welcome him as you would welcome me. If he has done you any wrong or owes you anything, charge it to me. I, Paul, am writing this with my own hand. I will pay it back, not to mention that you owe me your very self. I do wish, brother, that I may have some benefit from you in the Lord. Refresh my heart in Christ. Confident of your obedience, I write to you, knowing that you will do even more than I ask. Amen. Let us pray. O Lord, help us to trust not only you and in your salvation, but in one another, that we might trust each other with our lives, with our hearts, and with our dreams. We pray all of this in Jesus' name. Amen. This morning we're starting a sermon series called What If? We are going to be asking the question, what if, over the next several weeks, and I hope that we as a congregation will begin to ask the question, what if, on a regular basis. The reason for what if is the question of dreams. What if is the question of what could I do if there were no limits, if there was nothing holding me back, what would God call me to do? What am I capable of? What if I could do anything? What would I do? This is a series about dreaming. And when it comes to dreaming as a community, as a family of faith, the first step we must take, if we are going to dream together, if we are going to trust each other with our dreams, is to trust each other as deeply as possible. Trust each other in the way that Paul trusts Philemon. I want to go back to this letter. I want you all to think about what it must be like, not only to be Paul, but to be Onesimus. Onesimus is Philemon's slave. He is owned. And Paul says, Onesimus, come here. I have something I need you to do. I need you to take this letter to Philemon. I need you to take this letter to the one who owned you. And in it, I am giving him the choice to either continue to treat you as a slave or to start to treat you as a brother in Jesus Christ. Anybody want to deliver that letter as Onesimus? Doesn't sound like much fun, does it? You are going knowing you are going back to a man who has owned you and who may have treated you badly before he have hurts going with him. But on Simmons goes, he takes the letter. This is the kind of trust that we must show to one another through Jesus Christ. If we are going to live the life of dreamers, if we are going to bring about the kingdom of God as the people of God at Bethany Christian Church, we must be willing to trust each other deeply. And so I want to talk about what that looks like, what that means. Because it is the same trust that God has given to us. In this morning's scripture in Deuteronomy, God says, I have shown you, I have given you a choice between life and death, blessing and curse, good and evil. I have laid it out before you, and I trust you to make that choice. I trust you to choose life or death. I trust you to choose blessing or curse. I trust you to choose between good and evil. God chose to trust us. How many in here think that God may have made a mistake in trusting humanity? Look around, look at TV. But at the same time, think of the beauty. Think of the wonderful things you have seen that have come out of God's trust in humanity as well. The acts of love, the acts of care, the small things that have been a part of your life, the places where you have seen those who have chosen life and not death, good and not evil. Think of those things and realize that not everything humanity has done is bad. Not everything we have done as individuals is bad. Not everything that the Church of Jesus Christ has done in bad is bad. In fact, much of it is good and worth God's trust. The Deuteronomy scripture tells us that God has chosen to trust us even though we will hurt God. We will hurt God's kingdom. We will act in broken ways. We will act in hurtful ways towards one another, towards the body of Christ, towards the kingdom of God, towards another human being. God has chosen to trust us, and so we are called to offer each other the same kind of trust. Nadia Bolz-Weber, pastor in Denver of the Lutheran Church, tells anyone who is thinking about joining her church, and I want you all to hear this, listen to this. She tells anyone who's thinking about joining her church, before you join, I want you to know something. At some point in time, I will hurt you. Someone in this church will hurt you. Something will happen and it will hurt you because you have joined this church. Before you join this church, I need you to consider that. Who's signing up for that call? We don't like that. We don't like that idea, but you know something? That is a statement worthy of trusting. Who has ever had any kind of significant relationship, friendship, family member, romantic relationship, where the person that they are with hasn't hurt, hasn't wronged, hasn't done something that harmed them, whether intentional or unintentional? It is the most honest and trustworthy statement any human being can make. And so I want to say to you all here today, I hope that it never happens, but my experience as a man who makes many mistakes is that it might. I may hurt you, but I hope that you trust that I am trying to do what's best. This is a crazy kind of trust. This is the kind of trust that goes beyond rational thinking. This is the kind of trust that goes beyond the ways of the world in which we say, only trust those who have treated you right. Only trust those who have fully earned it 100%. So you should continue to trust your granddaughter, even though she squirted you with that nose. I really honestly believe that. And I don't think that's a tough statement to make. It's this kind of crazy trust that leads us into the land of dreams, that leads us into a place where we can share with one another our greatest desires, our deepest desires, our grandest dreams, our craziest thoughts, because we know that the people around us care about us, want what's best for us, and will offer us whatever support they can, even if they don't necessarily agree that it's the best decision we've ever made. It's the kind of crazy trust that leads a church to hire a silly little 29-year-old fresh out of seminary pastor. 4 years ago, y'all showed that kind of crazy trust. And I'm not going to say that I'm standing up here as a great example of what a good idea it was. It's been up and down. But the life we have shared together as a body of Christ, not only over the last 4 years, but over 123 years, ministry to Jesus Christ is a life that has required trust again and again and again. And it's the kind of trust that allows us to still be doing vibrant ministry here and now, right now, today. We continue to bring about life. We continue to offer the good news of Jesus Christ. The good news that God is not just active 2,000 years ago, but God is active right here, right now, in this church, in our lives. And when we trust each other, yes, we will make mistakes. We will be hurt. I guarantee it, if you are alive, you're going to be hurt. But I've got good news. God can work redemption through that. When we gather around the table, it always confused me when I was younger, and actually up until this very morning, often nights it confused me. Why do we say on the night Jesus was betrayed, he took the bread and broke it, he took the cup and blessed it? Why do we say on the night that he was betrayed? Because it reminds us that it was in Jesus' deepest trust and deepest betrayal that the redemption of the world comes to us. In one of the most hurtful moves in all scriptures, when Judas betrays Jesus Christ, we find redemption. So even in the hurt, even in the betrayal, even in the mistakes, even in the intentional, God can work redemption, and we must trust not only God, but one another, that we are working for that redemption, that we are working for that world, that we are working for the kingdom of God. And if we trust that, we can bring dreams that are only visions right now, that are only thoughts, that do not have any flesh and bones on them yet. We can take that question of what if, that question of possibility, and we can begin to do the work to make those dreams, to make those visions into a reality of the kingdom of God here on earth, here in this sanctuary, here in this community. We can take those dreams and we can make them real. But we must trust one another. Amen. If there is anyone here today who has not declared faith in the one who was betrayed, who showed the deepest trust and was betrayed, but brought about redemption and new life in Jesus Christ, we invite you to come forward and make a profession of faith in him today. If there is anyone who would like to join together with this body of Christ as we seek to make dreams and visions into reality, we invite you to come forward now. If there is anyone who would like to join with us by rededicating themselves, by saying, yes, I want to step back into the life of Jesus Christ, we invite you to come forward and do so as we stand and sing our hymn of invitation, number 494, Tell Though We Are With You. Let's stand and sing. first Sunday, we have our recessional hymn, but hang around. Stay seated and listen to her offering to us in music and in praise to God. Now, if you please bow for our benediction. As you go forth from this place, know that God has trusted you with the good news. Go and share it, that others might hear this good news and come to believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. It is in His name we pray. Amen.